Hi all, today we are going to see the evaluation of ABCD parameters and some numericals on the long transmission line. So let us see how the ABCD parameters can be calculated. So we have seen in the last class that the value of A is equal to D is equal to cos H of gamma L and B is equal to ZC into sin H of gamma L and C is equal to 1 by ZC into sin h of gamma l. So how to evaluate this hyperbolic functions, because analyzing this cos hyperbolic cos h sin h and these things we are very complex, and that too the second problem is there, we know the value of the gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta because it is also a complex value. So analyzing the complex hyperbolic functions is very complex. So this value of the alpha, this alpha is nothing but attenuation constant. This is in Nabers per unit length. So similarly, the value of the beta is the phase constant. The phase constant is in the radians per unit length. This gives how much is the phase shift, alpha gives how much is the attenuation. So now the calculating this hyperbolic functions, which are complex because gamma is complex, there are basically three methods. So first method is convergent series for real angle method. It is also called as real angle method. So in this method, what we do, this sin h of gamma l, so this can be written as sin h of alpha l plus j beta l, because that gamma I have just substituted. So this can be expanded as sin h of alpha l into cos beta l plus j times of cos h of alpha l into sin beta l. Similarly, this cos h of gamma l will be equal to cos h of alpha l plus j beta l. So this I can write as cos h of alpha l into cos beta l plus j times of sin h of alpha l into sin beta l. This way we have to do. So here calculating the value of sin beta l cos beta l is easy, but calculating the sin h of gamma l alpha l and cos h of alpha l is a complex, because you have to go for the hyperbolic function, you have to refer to the table and substitute them, which will be little tough. Let us see the easier method and the common method that is used. The second method is called as Maclaurin series. In the Maclaurin series, the sin h of gamma l can be expanded as gamma l plus gamma cube l cube divided by 3 factorial plus gamma to the power of 5 l to the power of 5 by 5 factorial, etc. Or if you are substituting the value of the gamma, so gamma l I can substitute as, because we know the value of gamma, gamma is equal to square root of y into z. So gamma l will be equal to that l, when it is going inside, this will become y into z into l square, or it is l into l. So y multiplied by l becomes capital Y and z multiplied by z becomes capital Z. So we can tell gamma z is nothing but gamma l is y into z, capital Y into capital Z. So I am just substituting that this becomes square root of yz into 1 plus, this will become yz by 3 factorial. 3 factorial if you expand, it becomes 6. Similarly, the second one will be, so the second one, because this gamma, you are taking the thing outside, gamma l outside. So this will become y square z square divided by the value of the next factorial. That means 5 factorial will be equal to 120 plus etc. It can be expanded. Generally for accuracy, only if you take the first two terms, these two terms, that is accurate and sufficient enough. And if you want much more accuracy, you can go up to third digit. No need to go for expansion higher than this. Only we have to take these three terms maximum. Generally two terms are sufficient. Now coming to cos h of gamma l, this cos h of gamma l can be expanded as 1 plus gamma square l square by 2 factorial plus gamma to the power 4 l to the power 4 by 4 factorial plus it expands. So this can be written as 1 plus yz divided by 2 factorial will be 2 into 1, that is 2, and this 4 factorial will be y square plus z square divided by 24 plus etc. So this way it will come. So we have to take again same thing, either two terms or the three terms, they are more than enough. Now You want to calculate the value of A is equal to D is equal to cos h of square root of y into z. Cos h of gamma l, that I can write like this. So this will be equal to directly the cos h of gamma l we have just derived now, yz by 2 plus y square z square by 24. Up to here you have to take, this is more than enough. Then coming to B, B is zc into sin h of gamma l is nothing but y into z. So this I can write as the zc is square root of z by y into sin h of gamma l we have seen is equal to yz multiplied by 1 plus yz by 6 plus y square z square divided by 120. This is what we have seen, plus etc. are there. So those things I am neglecting. So this will become z, because yy will cancel, square root of z into z will be z, 1 plus yz by 6 plus y square z square divided by 120. So in this value, using this manner, I can calculate this. Similar is the case for C. C is equal to 1 by zc into sin h of square root of yz, because it is gamma l. So this will be equal to square root of y by z into square root of yz into 1 plus yz by 6 plus y square z square by 120 plus y cube z cube divided by 5040. Like that you can go on expanding. So generally I told you 2 or 3 terms are sufficient, so I am taking only these 3 terms. So this I can write as y into 1 plus yz by 6 plus y square z square divided by 120. Just take up to this much, this will give the more accurate results, no need to depend on this thing. So there is one more third method also there. In the third method, it can be written like that, sin h of gamma l is equal to sin h of alpha l plus j beta l. So this I can write as e to the power of alpha l, e to the power of j beta l plus e to the power of minus alpha l into e to the power of minus j beta l divided by 2, or this I can write as 0.5 e to the power of alpha l at an angle of beta l minus e to the power of minus alpha l at an angle of minus beta l. This way you will write. Same thing is the case, cos h of gamma l is equal to, they just expand in the similar form. If you expand it, you will get it as 0.5 times of e to the power of alpha l at an angle of beta l plus e to the power of minus alpha l at an angle of minus beta l. This is what we get. So calculation of this one is also very tedious. Generally we go for the second method only, that is expansion method, for calculating any numerical. So let us take one numerical so that the complete concept what we have discussed will be clear to you. So I am taking one example, a 3-phase line is 500 kilometers long. The line constants are z is equal to 0.105 plus say 0.3768 ohms per kilometer. Y is equal to 0 plus j 2.822 into 10 to the power of minus 6 mho per kilometer. The line delivers 40 MVA at 0.9 power factor lag at 220 kV. Find the sending end voltage, current, power factor, MVA and power angle. This is what is asked. So the solution for this, how to solve this. So this will be the value of z. To calculate the capital Z, you have to multiply with the distance. So this will become 0.105 plus j 0.3768. This will be multiplied by 500. So this will be 52.5 plus j 188.4 ohms. This will be equal to 195.578 at an angle of 74.43 degrees. Similar is the case, y will be 0 plus j 2.822 into 10 to the power of minus 6. This multiplied by distance, this will be 0.001411 at an angle of 90 degrees. This is in mho, this is in ohms. So please remember this. So this is degrees, right? Okay, now y and z are calculated. So I can calculate my value of yz. If you multiply these two, I am directly writing answer 0.27596 at an angle of 164.429 degrees. So from this, I can calculate my value of A. We have just derived this 1 plus 5z by 2 plus yz whole square by 24. Up to third digit we are taking, up to third element. Generally up to 2 also will give same accurate result. So this will become 1 plus 0 point. So y, the value of y is, y into z is 27596, right? 27596 at an angle of 164.429 divided by 2 plus the same value, that means yz, whatever value is there, you just divide by 24. If you just substitute and calculate the value, I am directly writing the answer 0.8698 plus j 0.035397. This I can write as 0.8705 at an angle of 2.33. Because we know A is equal to D, this will be same as D only. So same, we can calculate B is equal to Z into 1 plus YZ by 6 plus YZ square divided by 120. So if you substitute this value, you will get this value as 0.000017 plus J 0.001349, or this I can write as 0.001349 at an angle of 90.722 degrees. So now the receiving end voltage will be, because it is given as 220 kV length, that means 220 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by root 3, this will become 127021. I am taking it as a reference, so I am taking as 0 degrees. So similar way, the IR is given as, IR can be calculated from MVA, it is given 40 MVA, so 40 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by root 3 times of VL, VL is 220 kV. So this will become, and angle is given there, the power factor is already given there, power factor is 0.9 lag. So 0.9 log, if you convert the angle, this will become minus 25.84. So this value will become 104.973 at an angle of minus 25.84 degrees. This is what we get. So now I can calculate my Vs is equal to A times of VR plus B times of IR. So this will be, A is 0.8705 at an angle of 2.33, that is the value of A, that then VR will be 127021 at an angle of 0 degrees, plus the value of B is 187.03 at an angle of 75.15. So this will be multiplied by 104.973 at an angle of minus 73.84. So if you calculate this, you will get this answer as 123280.86 plus J 19382.48. This is what we get. So this I can further simplify as 124795.23 at an angle of 8.935 degrees. So similar way, I can calculate my value of IS is equal to C times of VR plus D times of IR. So if you substitute, I am directly writing the answer 81.64 plus J times of 134.939. This will be 157.71 at an angle of 58.5 degrees. Now the sending end line voltage will be equal to root 3 times of the voltage that comes. The value that came is 124795.23. This will be 216.15 into the 10 to the power of 3 volts, or it is also called as kV. Similarly, sending end line current will be same as the phase current, because unless otherwise mentioned, it is a star connection only. So this will become 58.5 degrees. Now sending end power factor. So sending end power factor. So power factor at sending end. So the sending end power factor will be cos of the angle between voltage and current. So cos of the angle between voltage and current will be, this is 58.8 minus 8.935. This will be equal to 0.645, because current is angle is greater than the voltage angle. So this will be lead, because current is leading. Okay, so please remember this, because this angle is plus. So now sending end MVA is equal to root 3 times of VL is 216.15 into current is 157.71. If you calculate this, you will get it as 59.042 MVA. Here it is in kV, so voltage in kV, so 10 to the power of 3, you will get this angle. So now calculating the power angle. Power angle is the angle between sending end voltage and the receiving end voltage. So this will be 8.935. So I hope how to calculate the ABCD parameters and how to solve the long transmission lines is clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.